Every morning I get the privilege to meet such exciting and inspiring people, and this Thursday is no different. I've just spent the last 20 minutes talking to this gentleman, and I can tell you you're in for a wonderful time today on Books and Blogs. He's the CEO, founder, and director of Passion Biz Kenya, and he's also a success coach. He helps you write your book. He's an author as well, and a host of so many other things, not forgetting motivational speaker. Mr. James Karundu, welcome to Books and Blogs.
Thank you.
And I hope we will just have a great time this morning.
Looking forward.
Okay, I'm going to try and find out where to start with you, but maybe your journey into becoming an author. What's the background to that?
Well, I started out as a lecturer. I'm a teacher.
Okay.
And apart from that, I'm a mathematician. In fact, I always say I'm the only mathematician who is also a motivational speaker, so there's something there.
There must be something.
And the journey began with my teaching background and being sent out there to teach mathematics. And people always have this attitude about maths. And I call this attitude ngumu sana. So before class, I would talk to the students and I would encourage them, look, maths is doable. You can do it. Just believe in yourself. Just give it a try. And then before every class, I would try and give them a pep talk. And then I found that I'm loving the pep talk idea.
Yeah.
And I would look for ideas, I would look for what to share with them. So over time, that's where the beginnings of the speaking, the beginnings of the mentoring, away from the normal teaching of maths and English.
Mm-hmm.
So what happened then was I started realizing I'm having all these ideas. And in after some time, I started realizing this is something I'm called to do. I love reading books. I love reading motivational books. And I started getting the idea, you know, I can do this.
Yeah.
And that's how I wrote my first book, 7 Keys for Success Beyond Chance. I did my first book and it came out, but it wasn't exactly what I wanted and how I wanted. So I ended up revising it and redoing it.
Okay.
And that is what metamorphosized into one of my books, which is Go For It.
Yeah. How long did it take you to do that one book, the first one?
The first one book took about a year to do.
Oh.
Yes. However, let me explain the year.
Yes.
So it's not a year hunkered behind a desk and burning the midnight oil writing. No. It's a year of procrastination. It's a year of starts and stops.
Okay.
It's a year of wondering whether I'm really meant to do this. Isn't what I'm sharing so simple? It's a year of doing a lot of research, digging into other people's materials, and trying to steal an idea here and there. And then later on realizing that what is needed is truly my own ideas.
Being authentic.
Being authentic.
Yes.
Yes.
And the book must have done very well, because then you ended up, you know, releasing more books.
Yes.
Subsequently over the years.
This is the interesting thing,
mm-hmm.
that even though I always felt this book is not fully done, this book has many issues, I wish I could have done it better, people just loved it and they talked about how my imperfect book, according to the way I'm looking at it, has changed their lives. That's what
wow.
I found truly amazing.
Yeah. Let's talk about the message. We touched on it just before the show began, where you were telling me it's not about me, I'm just a conduit, a messenger for the message you carry.
Yes.
And maybe that's what, you know, the people who give you feedback with your first book, they just saw the message.
Absolutely. This is really what is interesting, that they saw the message and they saw something that touched them and they saw an answer to what they're looking for. And that is what I usually tell my mentees. I mentor authors, I mentor aspiring authors. That the key thing here is, let's get clear on your message, let's get it out. And obviously you don't put out a shoddy book, but you can't be too perfect. You've got to put it out there, send it out there, start getting the feedback. Otherwise you will never get it done.
Yeah. How do you deal with aspiring authors who have self-doubt, which I'm sure you went through with your book number one?
Yes.
How do you get them started to go for it?
First of all, anytime you're starting any endeavor, whether it's writing a book, starting a business, anytime you're about to take a bold step, something that is truly out of your comfort zone, and more so, something that comes out of your heart, the first thing that you handle is self-doubt, fears, uncertainties. Those are the first things you navigate. But so it's nothing unusual. That's
okay.
Number one.
Okay.
It's nothing unusual. But the second point is this. The reason why people feel the fear and the self-doubt is they are missing three things.
Okay.
Number one is clarity. It's clarity about the message that you have. Clarity about how to, you know, connecting the dots. Number two that they are missing is embracing the journey. Because it's like you want to go and climb a mountain, you know it's going to be tough, there are going to be terrains that are going to be difficult to handle. But the moment you embrace that, then something changes.
Yeah.
And number three, part of the fear is this. It's called flying solo. When you attempt to write a book by yourself, you are putting that whole burden of the doubt and the whole burden of trying to start a journey without the equipment, without support. So for majority of the people, it's because maybe they're not aware that somebody can help them.
And also, I need you to touch on something really profound you said to me, which is, when you become an author, it's like becoming a parent.
Yes.
How so?
Well, let's put it this way. Remember we said one of the things that one must do is to embrace the calling.
Yes.
To embrace the assignment.
Mm-hmm.
And when you embrace it, then it comes with its own issues and challenges. When you embrace it, it comes with particular responsibilities. And the example is when you become a parent. You know, before you're a parent, your life is just normal. It's you and whatever else that you're doing. But when you have a little one squealing and crying and giggling and
needing your attention.
Yes.
Yes.
Something has shifted. And as an author, then some of the duties and also burdens that come with it include the following. Let me give you a few of them.
Yes, sure.
One of them is that you're the custodian of a message. There is a message that has been downloaded. There is clarity that you've gotten. There are experiences that you've gone through. And you have no right to try and edit them, to try and put them in a palatable way. You share it as it is. Because that is the message with your clarity, with your experience. That message as it is, you have no right to tamper with it. You know, you deliver it as it comes to you. You deliver it as it has been downloaded onto you. Now, let me give you another element to it. So when you become an author, you are also a guide. You are the automatic guide for people.
Okay.
People see you as somebody who knows the way. You're an automatic mentor.
Wow.
Whether you, absolutely. Because people will come to you and
yes.
They expect answers from you.
Yes.
And if things are not working in the country, they look to those who seem to know something. And you are one of them if you're an author.
Is that how your mentorship training courses began?
Yes. Let's put it this way. Whenever you write a book, the book, the mentorship, and the speaking go together. That's how the three of them go together. Because people must hear you speaking. As they hear you speaking, they want to go with something from you. It's like a musician who comes and sings in church, and then you ask, hey, do you have a DVD? I really loved the music that you sang there. Can I go and listen further? So the speaking gives one the opportunity, number one, to create awareness of what it is that you've written about, but also to give an opportunity. And also the speaking becomes almost like a taster.
Okay.
So speaking, authorship,
and
mentorship go together, and they are all part of the same chain. Even when I work with my authors, once you finish writing the book, even as you write the book, not even as you write the book, you have to be thinking in terms of what sort of mentorship can I offer after the person reads the book. So one must have that thought process even as you write the book.
So, James, what I hear you say is it's not over once this is done.
No.
If anything, you've just begun. The work has just begun.
In fact, you've just begun. That is why, as an author, you need to have many books. you're taking people on a journey. So my first book, Seven Keys, gave back to Go For It. Go For It, after it, I had the stepping stones. After stepping stones, the next one is on entrepreneurship. The next one might be on how to write a book. You know, so the journey never ends.
It's forever. It's almost eternal.
Let's put it this, it's an evolving journey. Okay, one more thing about writing.
Yes.
That your life gets changed through the process. Let's put it this way. You see, you are undertaking a journey where you're digging within. And what you're digging within, usually it's painful memories. Usually it is failures. Usually it is bad decisions. How else do you get the insight? You get the insights from the mistakes. So, so you get the insights. I forgot to tell you that. It's the mistakes you've made. I'm sure you've heard of this, that it is your mess that becomes the what?
The message.
The message. That's yes. How it goes. So as you do this, your life is transformed because you start getting healing.
Yes.
There is some sort of cathartic
thing
that happens because you start getting healing. These are things that were inside you, and you wonder why you feel called, because it's your journey to healing those things that have been holding you back.
You know, like I said to you before we started, like this conversation
yes.
is more for me than uh-huh. for the viewer because, uh-huh. Uh-huh. because you're speaking into those fears, into those, you know, inhibitions of do I not. But now when you put it like that and you saying that we are just, you know, a conduit.
Absolutely.
To release the message.
Absolutely.
And you release it and there begins your healing.
Absolutely.
I think it's phenomenal.
And as you heal, others heal. And this is something interesting, let me just tell you. This book here is alive. This is what's amazing, that the book is like a living thing. And that is why it's almost like something in the womb that needs to come out.
Hmm.
You see, a particular story needs to come out.
Yeah.
And just the same way people have more than one child, the womb metaphorically can
yes.
produce
many
books.
Wow.
Each similar, but distinct.
Yes, I get you. I get you.
And always with some sort of common connection.
Yes.
That is
There's
how it
a thread.
Goes. There's a thread.
Yes. Ooh. Yes. And you teach authors. You have a training session as well.
Absolutely.
For authors, you
Absolutely.
Teach. Okay, tell us more about
well,
it.
Well, I have a program called Write Your Book Now. And I work with aspiring authors. And what I help them to do is get three things. Number one is clarity. It's when you have clarity, then you're able to embrace that calling. Number two is I give them a roadmap, because what they're missing is a roadmap. And number three, I give them the accountability. Without accountability, you will never get it done.
Hmm.
So we work together it's typically a weekly class. It's a weekly journey.
Okay.
Because you've got to be accountable week on week on week
yes.
on week.
Yes.
Together we work together for 90 days. You focus your time. You make the space, you will get it done within 90 days.
90 days.
Yes.
And you also publish as well.
Absolutely.
You learned the ropes to that.
Well, everything is self-taught. Remember I said the mistakes.
Yes.
Including how my first book was done, and I thought it was the responsibility of the publisher to ensure the book comes out right. Yet it is my responsibility as the author, especially the route that I teach people, which is called self-publishing. It is my responsibility to ensure that the end product comes out right. There are others to help you, but you can't leave the job to them.
Yes.
So I've made many mistakes, and I want people to avoid those mistakes.
Yes.
And that is what has led me to start my own company that not only mentors people on how to start the journey and guides them, but we have all the professionals required, right from the editors, the layout people, including printing. We've partnered with a lot of people. So it's a one-stop shop that we help you to move from idea in your head to manuscript. And once a manuscript is done, you go through the other process, then you have a book in
your hand. Amazing. One of the authors you've worked with is someone very special to you.
Yes.
Isabella G. Mateka, your mother-in-law.
Yes.
Now, if your mother-in-law can look to you to help write her book, then it must be very, very good.
Well, I think it's a calling.
Yes.
That I've embraced. And I don't know about being very good. The key thing here is I know the way.
Yeah.
I know how to get it done.
Yes.
And I also have an open heart to help whoever it is. It doesn't matter whether it is a family member or not a family member.
Right.
It doesn't matter whether one has the money or not the money.
Yeah.
We look to see how we can get it to go out.
Yeah.
So for me, it's a call that I have embraced. And I have a target, by the way.
Okay, what's that?
100 published authors.
100 published authors. By by when?
This is called a BHAG. The big, hairy, audacious
goal. Yes.
Let's say by election time.
That's less than a year.
I don't know how, but
that's phenomenal.
It's doable.
I hope to be one of the people that you mentor, by the way.
Absolutely.
To release my first book. I am saying I'm putting myself on the frying pan.
Yes.
And saying, I hope I will glean a lot from your writing program.
Well, my challenge is for you just to declare, I'm going to get my book done.
I have been declaring that for the last 3 years.
Maybe you can do it afresh.
maybe I need to do more than declare, but you know what? Let's talk about some of the authors that you're working with now currently. Would you like to maybe just touch a bit on them?
Yes. I'm working with one of the authors I'm working with is one who has a very interesting story.
Okay.
I'll just keep the name and say
private.
But
okay.
Yes. But this is somebody who has an amazing journey because they entered a particular vocation. One of these vocations where it's a lifelong vocation. And a lot of people enter that particular vocation and it is for life. And it was very traumatic for her to get into the vocation. She was once a nun, and it was a major journey, becoming a nun, and also stepping out. And you can imagine all the thoughts and all the conversations with God as to whether, is this what I'm meant to do? Is this part of your purpose, and so on? And somehow we found a way to put that together into a book.
That's riveting.
Absolutely.
That's riveting.
Yes, and then we have somebody else who, this is somebody who has always felt the need to share what comes from deep within, but that has never found an outlet. But now it has found an outlet in the form of a book. The other gentleman that I'm working with, this is somebody who has had a very interesting history. And he's found himself in so many scenarios, including near death, including scenarios where there was no, you know, setbacks, and so on and so on. And he has come to conclude that life is like that. So he's just sharing about the struggles and the lessons he has learned.
Right. But his perception of life has changed, though.
Yes.
Right now.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yes.
When an author comes to you and you find out the kind of story that they want to tell, are you selective in what you want to help with or publish? Or do you judge, maybe? That's
no,
what I'm trying
no,
to
No, not
ask.
Really. In fact, how the conversation goes is this. At no cost, for somebody wanting to write a book, all they need to do is just book an appointment with me.
That's all?
At no cost. Come and share with me what you're all about and what it is that you want to do. And then as I listen to you, for me it's an intuitive process and I'm able to just get what is it that needs to come out. And we're able to co-create what the book is going to be about. I can't do it by myself.
Right.
It's a co-creation.
Right.
And the moment we get what the book is going to be about, it's done. Because you can feel it. You can even just know that this is it.
Yeah.
And from there, it's a matter of the title. From there, again, it's a process. It's not instant. That's why it's a weekly thing. That's why my work involves a lot of private one-to-one conversations. And what I'm good at is the intuitive thing of kind of helping somebody get clarity and bring it out.
Mm.
And once we bring it out, you know, we're able to get the chapters,
yes,
or how the story should flow. And once we've done that, it's a matter of you going to start putting it down.
Yeah.
And I have a way in which I have a schedule which we follow. I have, I call it a mixed grill. You know, I'm looking for the right word here. It's, what is it? It's almost like a scorecard.
Okay.
Where this item must be there, this item must be there. So when you start writing the book, if it's a chapter, make sure you have the right quote, make sure the introduction is there, make sure we get the lessons.
The must-haves.
Uh-huh, those must-haves.
Yes.
So it's a plug-and-play scenario.
Hmm.
And it's doable.
It sounds, you make it sound so easy.
Because it is.
So, how can people get in touch with James Karundu?
Okay. Now, for someone watching this and they're wondering, how can you get in touch with me? Now, it's quite easy. You need to go to my website, which is jameskarundu.com. When you go there, you'll read my profile, you'll read a lot of stories, and my contacts are there. But the best of all, also, one can also connect with me on social media, facebook.com, look for James Karundu. But also, one can simply send me an email at jameskarundu@gmail.com. And let's start the conversation. If you're seeing this and it's speaking to you, it means you are meant to do something about it. And there's a high chance that there are those who are watching this and you've been having a book idea, you've been sitting on it, you've started, you've given up, you've listened to the voices in their head, you've listened to other voices that have told you that you can't do it. I want to let you know you can do it. And if you're watching this, this is the time.
Amazing. Before we go, tell me about your work as a Kumon instructor.
Okay. Okay, well, so this is the interesting thing, that a lot of work that I do has to do with mentoring people, starting from the little ones. And it's a major blessing to be able to mentor the little ones. And many years ago, about 15 years ago, I came across a program called Kumon Maths and English. It's an after-school program for helping children improve maths and English in a very organized and structured way. And but this is the secret. Well, this is what it's really all about.
Okay.
It's really a life skills program.
Oh.
Yes, that uses math and English. Because it's the same thing. Look, kids come when they're struggling, or the parent says, my child can't do this, can't do this. And it's the same conversation I was talking about earlier. We sit down, we have a chat, and then we do a bit of an assessment, and we see where the child can begin. We create a roadmap, and a child begins from success, day one. It's called the easy starting point. And it's the same thing that I do when I'm mentoring you to write your book, to harness your brilliance. So I run two study centers.
Okay.
One in South Sea. I've run that for 15 years. I used to run it even on a part-time basis when I was employed. I run another center in Kileleshwa at Kasuku Center. That's also where I'm based. And also, that's also where people can come and see me if they need to see me. And that's also where I run my trainings. So I have my own training venue, which is at my Kumon Center.
At Kasuku Center.
At Kasuku Center in Kileleshwa, yes.
Okay. You spoke earlier about your mess becoming your message. And you're currently working on your, is it the fourth or the fifth book?
The fourth book.
Yes. What is it that you've had to overcome that you found the insights to put on a book for people to glean? What, in short, what has your mess been?
Fantastic. Number one is about believing in yourself. Because quite often, you get some particular insights. You find yourself kind of always a little bit different from everybody else. You find yourself drawn to some particular things, and then you start labeling yourself as different or weird, or wondering, is there something wrong with me? So one of my challenges was believing in myself.
Ah.
Yes.
That
absolutely.
Is why you're incredibly passionate.
Yes, and you can see this seemingly confident person who seems
totally
unstoppable.
Yeah.
But that's where I came from.
Whew.
Yes.
Unbelievable. So that,
exactly. And then the other one is waiting too long to get started with some of these things. Because, as I said, a lot of things that stop people, including me, in the past was lack of finances. I don't have the money. And then you're still spending money on so many other things. So I'm glad that I found somebody who could allow me to pay by installments. So you give a check. That's my first publishers. They're called Flame Keepers. They gave me a chance to pay by installments. So I got started. They did not do that. I would never do it. That is why I have compassion for people, especially this person who is struggling to come up with the payment.
Mm, my goodness, I get it.
You get it.
The circle is full, or what do you call it? It's,
yes.
It's all come together.
Absolutely.
Now.
And this is what happens when you start taking bold steps. Because I've been held back by fear and the whole thing of feeling exposed and wondering, don't they know this? And so on and so on. So it's when you start taking those bold steps, you create something called an upward spiral. You start becoming a bit more bolder. You start discovering it's not life-threatening. You know, you can do this. You start feeling your way. You start learning how to do it. You stumble 100 times. You give up. You come back again. You read an inspirational book. But the one thing that has helped me is mentors. I've worked with many mentors. I've paid almost $1 million working with some of the best mentors in the world. And that has helped me to sharpen my edge and to really, really hone in on what I'm supposed to do.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, I celebrate your success and your passion as well. It's a very fresh new thing, especially in our society. To just find someone who's willing to hold another's hand and guide them through the process. Because I'm sorry, I mean, our society is very selfish.
Yes.
I just want to keep everything to myself, enjoy the success by myself. But to meet someone who wants to share it is very refreshing.
Something of interest. One of my fears was that I'm giving too much away. That I'm giving too much away. Am I not giving away everything? But the truth is, there is so much in each and every person. You cannot give away everything. Even if you give it away, more comes.
You'll be filled.
Yeah, because that's, I give talks every single month, free talks. I give free consultation, and I still have so much more to give.
I love that, and I thank you. And
when
you have those free talks, let us know, so we can let our viewers know as well.
Yes.
And they can, you know, partake in that.
Absolutely.
You just never know, but I am so thankful and humbled that, you know, you're raising the next generation, even this generation.
Yes.
And motivating some of us and to go for it. Thank you for gracing our show today.
You're welcome, and I'm so glad.
Thank you. So that's James Karundo. I know you've been inspired. If you need more details on how to get across to him, if you didn't catch when he shared his social media emails or address, just go to our social media sites and you'll find his contacts there. And then perhaps you can start your upward spiral journey. See, I'm using your terms already.
Yes.
You can start your journey to releasing that book. Don't go too far. After the break, we feature Restaurant of the Week.